once we get in the 2010s, once we get into now, you can see all sorts of people who are unafraid to be themselves, on record or in the way they look, right? Where hip hop is not gonna be afraid of skinny jeans anymore. It's not gonna be afraid of slightly androgynous stuff. And so you get this incredible moment that goes along with a millennial embrace of the non-binary, right?
The room is so big now that people's style of dress, it's a little hard to put the finger on that.
I think the internet just came in and was like, this is gonna bring the truth of what we already are anyway.
Yeah, it's no line, it's all blurred. That's the beauty of the internet. It kinda just took us back to square one, where it was just like creation.
Now more than ever, you're granted the tools to decide what you truly love and what you're truly drawn to.
I would say fashion right now is in an era of sampling. You know, it's like taking things that have previously existed and putting them in a new context.
If you said 90s hip hop or a 90s rapper, and then you said a 2017 rapper, like, I would just imagine this guy in polo, Tim's, and then this guy now with like a Gucci floral suit. So like clearly there's been this seismic shift.
The place where we've reached now in culture is a place where you try to kind of transcend the time period, and it's more about not necessarily focusing on those things. We're getting too lost in it so that you can speak beyond them.
I mean, it's always gonna be about pushing. It's always gonna be about pushing a boundary. It's always gonna be about crossing a boundary. It's always gonna be about, can this look some way that it hasn't looked before? That could be about drawing on the past.
You know, there's always people that are like, I was born in the wrong era. But for me, in terms of fashion and clothing, there are things that stay classic for a reason. And, you know, you can put somebody in a pair of like classic Levi's 501 jeans, like Doc Martens shoes, a plaid Ben Sherman shirt, and a fishtail parka. And you couldn't tell if they were from 1950 or 2016, depending on how well they wore it or how they pulled it off.
The most interesting thing that's happening right now is street culture sucking up avant-garde fashion.
With the ascendancy of hip-hop, hip-hop stars, hip-hop culture, hip-hop fashion lines, now they have that artistic creative freedom.
You know, if you look at like the biggest campaigns, now it's about getting that artist. You get the right artist in the clothes, and it's hip-hop artists.
If you look at hip-hop and rap and how that culture started, they were sort of on the outside looking in. They aspired to be a part of fashion, and now they are.
Again, this creeping of really weird avant-garde or faux avant-garde aesthetics and presentation styles into the realm of a worldwide pop hip-hop musician.
Now you got Kanye trying to design high-end European avant-garde fashion.
He's someone who is interested in all areas of art and creativity. He's just into fashion, he's into music, obviously, there's film. So you have this sense of some artists who think of themselves as 360, that they can do everything and anything, or at least try it.
You can't just be a pure creative anymore. You have to know the business side. If you look at an artist like Beyonce or Rihanna, you know, they are well aware that what they're doing is not just creating music, they are creating a brand universe.
The 2010s also, of course, is when social media basically took over our entire lives.
On one hand, it's great, but at the same time, I think I kind of miss a little bit of that passion that people had for really like digging.
We live on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Periscope, whatever the hell else. Artists now, an extension of their brand and their music and their creativity has to be their social media platform.
You know, you can't simply just make music. You have to create experiences now. You have to really flesh out a narrative and a world for your fans to access and inhabit, and then find ways to keep them coming back.
The golden age of our era happened in the early 2000s, which is when it first came to bear that we have a new frontier. But we're starting to figure out what is the standard. What is the new paradigm? And the new paradigm is gonna have to include something that is more intimate than what we currently see now.
I think people are gonna get tired of the fakeness of things. I feel like things will go in the opposite direction. The music won't become so dependent on technology anymore. You know, more people will come out and pop out of the game, giving like the realest experiences possible to people.
I mean, the next thing that's coming, I am in the faintest idea.
There's gonna have to be something that connects us more than a screen. It's who knows how each artist takes on that challenge, but it'll happen.
With everything accumulating and coming together, the next period is gonna be really interesting and really exciting to see where music goes. I think that some of the greatest artists are living right now and making art right now. It's a really exciting time to be alive.